was dark and stormy night, the kind of night that would make you walk fast and keep looking over your shoulder, the kind of night with secrets hiding in the shadows. Something fishy was going on, and the townspeople were talking. There was a mystery brewing, and it was going to take some detective work to work out why a certain someone was missing.
Talk to us.
Not the adults. We'll talk to the kids around here.
Good idea.
So we might be able to locate Mr. Jonah, but first we need to round up the usual suspects. Talk came easy. Finding answers was harder. The search led to the shadowy warehouses, joints, and dives around the port of Joppa.
Hannah, come here for a moment. I know a lot of the dock workers come to your family's inn. Did you hear anything unusual happening there?
The other day I was helping my mother serve up the stew when this weird-looking old man sat at the table. He was raving about how God told him to go to Nineveh and preach to the people over there.
So that's where he is?
No. He said he wasn't going. Said he didn't like the Ninevites. He was afraid if he preached, they'd repent and God would save him.
I thought that was the way it was supposed to work.
I don't know.
The Ninevites are Gentiles. They aren't like us. They are our enemies. Maybe that's why Jonah didn't want God to save him.
So Jonah didn't go to Nineveh. Where did he go?
He got on the ship going to Tarshish.
Now that's important because Nineveh is to the east. And Tarshish is to the west.
I can tell you one thing. That guy was running from God as fast as he could.
He said he worshiped the Lord God of heaven, and
And everybody knows this. Great God is always gnashing the seas.
Thing you remember, and why do you smell like that?
It'll go easier if you come clean now. Okay, my name is Jonah. God told me to go to Nineveh, but I went to Tarshish instead.
We already know that.
I was on this boat, and there was a storm, and they cast lots. I knew it was my God who caused the storm, so I told the crew to throw me overboard, and they did.
We know that, too.
There's some secrets a man needs to keep to himself. Stories better left untold. Stories so bizarre, no one would believe them.
Jonah preached the right, but when God spoke to him, because he got so angry he went inside of the ground line. Then God sent me to cut him down, and Jonah just sat there pouting.
Pouting? Prophets are supposed to pout?
I'm just telling you what happened.
So there you have it, the tale of a man caught up in a whirlpool of a circumstance. But if you want the story all tied up with a bow, don't look for a motive. Look at the character. I mean, Jonah was narrow-minded, stubborn, judgmental, grumpy, petty, prejudiced, and pig-headed. In other words, human. The perfect candidate for a miracle.
You got it!